In this series, we will look at autoencoders. In this video, we will look at the basics of autoencoders and dimensionality reduction using autoencoder models. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English. My voice is generated by AI, text-to-speech. Let's look at the full table of contents. In Chapter 1, we will look at the basic concepts of autoencoders. In Chapter 2, we will look at dimensionality reduction using autoencoders. We will build fully connected autoencoder and CNN autoencoder models to reduce the dimensionality of MNIST images. In Chapter 3, we will look at noise reduction using autoencoders. We will build a CNN autoencoder model to reduce noise and motion blur in MNIST images. In Chapter 4, we will look at sparse autoencoders. Let's impose sparsity constraints on autoencoders by applying KL divergence or L1 activity regularization. And let's apply a sparse autoencoder to the MNIST dataset. In Chapter 5, we will look at anomaly detection. Let's use an autoencoder model to perform credit card fraud detection. Finally, in Chapter 6, we will look at variational autoencoder, VAE, a type of generative model. Let's generate MNIST images using a variational autoencoder model. An autoencoder is a network trained so that its output is as similar as possible to the input data, as shown in the figure below. An autoencoder neural network is an unsupervised learning algorithm that applies backpropagation. Autoencoders have two main components, an encoder and a decoder. The encoder typically reduces the dimensionality of the input data X to produce a latent vector Z. Conversely, the decoder reconstructs the original data X from the latent vector Z, which is a reduced representation of X. The goal of an autoencoder is to minimize the difference between the original input and the reconstructed output, a measure known as the reconstruction error. The reconstruction error can be simply measured by the mean squared error. An autoencoder can be configured as a single layer, as shown in the left figure below, or as multiple layers, called a stacked autoencoder, as shown in the right figure. Stacked autoencoders allow the network to learn hierarchical representations of the input data X, with each layer capturing more complex features. The concept of autoencoder was first introduced in the 1980s. Early works on autoencoder were used for dimensionality reduction or feature learning. Since then, many types of autoencoder have been proposed by different researchers and successfully applied in many fields, such as generative models, computer vision, speech recognition, and natural language processing. Autoencoders can be applied to dimensionality reduction, noise removal, anomaly detection, generative models, etc. Next, let's look at dimensionality reduction. Dimensionality reduction is a method to transform a high-dimensional feature space into a low-dimensional feature space while capturing as many important features of the original data as possible. The example below shows the process of encoding MNIST images into k-dimensional vectors and then decoding them into the original images. We construct an autoencoder with an encoder and a decoder as follows. The encoder and decoder can be composed of fully connected networks, CNNs, LSTMs, etc. In this example, both the encoder and decoder are fully connected networks. In the next example, we will look at a CNN encoder-decoder network. Convert 2D MNIST images to 784-dimensional vectors and feed them into the encoder. Each of these vectors can be represented as a point in a 784-dimensional space. Similar images might be clustered in this space like this. The outputs of the encoder are k-dimensional vectors. These vectors are the compressed representations of the input images x. Each of these vectors can also be represented as a point in a k-dimensional space. Similar vectors can also be clustered in this space as follows. These vectors are fed into a decoder, which outputs images that are as similar as possible to the original images. The reconstruction error of this model is computed, and the parameters of the encoder and decoder are updated via backpropagation. That is, the parameters of this model are updated so as to minimize the reconstruction error. Minimizing the reconstruction error makes the original and output images more similar. Now, let's implement an autoencoder model for dimensionality reduction. We are going to build an autoencoder model consisting of fully connected networks, as shown in the example below. The encoder and decoder each consist of multi-layered, fully connected networks. These numbers are the number of neurons in each layer. The number of neurons in the output layer of the encoder is 2. This is to represent the 784-dimensional input data as 2-dimensional vectors. The outputs of the encoder are the latent vectors of input images x. It is not common to reduce input data by this much, but we reduced it to 2-dimensional vectors to display them in a 2-dimensional space. During training, we fit the encoder and decoder to the training images. Once training is complete, we can obtain the latent vectors of the test image using only the encoder. The distribution of the latent vectors in 2-dimensional space is as follows. You can see that similar images are clustered together in this space. That is, the latent vectors contain a lot of important information about the input images. Now, let's implement an autoencoder model for dimensionality reduction. And let's compare this with the dimensionality reduction result by principal component analysis, PCA. Read the MNIST dataset and split it into training and test data. We build an autoencoder model shown in the figure on the right. The outputs of the encoder are 2-dimensional vectors. We used a linear activation function in this layer. And we applied L2 activity regularization to prevent the outputs from becoming too large. The output layer of the decoder uses a sigmoid activation function. This is because the MNIST images are normalized to values between 0 and 1. Create and compile a model for training. We used a binary cross-entropy loss for reconstruction error. This is a regression problem, but since MNIST images are normalized to values between 0 and 1, we can use binary cross-entropy loss. Additionally, we create an encoder model to obtain the latent vectors of the input images x. The output of this model is zenc. Fit this model to the training data. The batch size is set to 500, and the number of iterations is set to 300. Let's take a visual look at the history of training and test losses. During training, the training error and the test error are reduced like this. Let's check the results. We feed the test data into the encoder model and obtain the latent vectors of the test data. And we plot the latent vectors in a two-dimensional space. The results are as follows. This is the result of projecting the 784-dimensional MNIST images into a two-dimensional space. Next, let's use Principal Component Analysis, PCA, to reduce the MNIST images to two dimensions. Let's use Kernel PCA. Since the MNIST data is too large for PCA to work well, we only use 10,000 pieces of training data and 5,000 pieces of test data. The results are as follows. This is also the result of projecting the 784-dimensional MNIST images into a two-dimensional space. Both results show clusters of similar vectors. Projecting the images into a higher-dimensional space can make the vectors less likely to overlap and make clustering clearer. Let's run this code. We got the following results. Next, let's create an autoencoder model consisting of convolutional layers and use this model to reduce the dimensionality of the input images. The encoder consists of 2D convolutional layers, and the decoder consists of 2D transposed convolutional layers. The encoder reduces the dimensionality of an input image, and the decoder expands the reduced representation back to the dimensions of the original input image. The example below is a model that reduces a 28 by 28 image to a 14 by 14 image. During training, we fit the encoder and decoder to the training images. Once training is complete, we can obtain the reduced image of a test image using only the encoder. Before implementing this model in code, let's briefly review the 2D transpose convolution process. The transpose convolutional layer is an upsampling layer that produces output feature maps that are larger than the input feature maps. Applying a transpose convolution with a 2x2 kernel and stride 1 to a 2x2 input feature map produces a 3x3 feature map as follows. If the stride is 2, a 4x4 feature map is generated. The source for this example is this site. If we feed the input feature map of this example into Keras's conv2d transpose class, we get the following results. We can see that the results are identical to what we calculated. Applying a transposed convolution with a 2x2 kernel and stride 1 to a 3x3 input feature map produces a 4x4 feature map as follows. Next, let's implement a CNN autoencoder model for dimensionality reduction. Read the MNIST dataset and split it into training and test data. Set the number of filters in the convolutional layers to 10. Build a CNN autoencoder model. Create an input layer. Image data of size 28 by 28 by 1 is fed to the input layer. The 1 at the end is the number of channels. MNIST images are grayscale, so there is only one color channel. Add padding to the top, bottom, left, and right of the input data. Then, the size of the input data will be 30 by 30 by 1. Next, we add a 2D convolutional layer. The number of filters is 10, and the kernel size is 3 by 3. And the stride is set to 2. This is the encoder, and it outputs 10 images of size 14 by 14. The 10 at the end is the number of filters. These are the reduced representations of the input images. Next, we create a decoder. Add a 2D transposed convolutional layer. Setting the stride to 2 makes the output feature map size twice the input feature map size. This layer will then output 10 images of size 28 by 28. The last 10 is the number of filters. Finally, we add a 2D convolutional layer. Setting the number of filters to 1 will output images of size 28 by 28 by 1. This has the same dimensions as the input image. The activation function is set to sigmoid. This is because the MNIST images are normalized to values between 0 and 1. Create and compile a model for training. We use binary cross-entropy loss. Additionally, we create a model to obtain the encoder output. Fit this model to the training data. During training, the training error and the test error are reduced like this. Next, let's visualize the images of the test data. The results are as follows. Finally, let's reduce the images of the test data. Feed the test data into the encoder model. The output of the encoder is 14 by 14 by 10. Each of the 10 filters produces a feature map of size 14 by 14. We visualize the 14 by 14 images, which are the average of the images generated by each filter. The results are as follows. The 28 by 28 images have been reduced to 14 by 14 images. The figure below illustrates this process. Let's run this code. We got the following results. So far, we have looked at dimensionality reduction using autoencoders. In the next video, we'll look at how to reduce noise and motion blur using an autoencoder.